My name is Magnus Gustafsson, and I'm head of global business development at Biovian, a Nordic viral vector CDMO based in Finland. I will tell you shortly about our services. Biovian was founded in 2003, 18 years ago. It's a privately owned company with a solid balance sheet. It's located in Turku, Finland, and it was founded by 5 co-founders. 4 of those are still active in the management, and so are many of the employees in the company, now having been employed for 18 years. On the experience level, we have worked on 400 clinical GMP batches so far. The education level amongst our employees are very high. More than 50% have a master or a PhD degree. The retention rate is very high, more than 96%, meaning that the competence stay in the company. Since 2013, we have worked with more than 100 clients worldwide. We have more than 100 employees, and we are a pure fee-for-service CDMO, meaning that you are free to tech transfer in when you want to, and you can tech transfer out when you want to. We never add any proprietary technologies to your processes, thereby adding royalties. We have 4,000 square meters of facilities, and the company is inspected by the Finnish authorities, FIMEA, belonging to EMA, and we have also been inspected by the US FDA a couple of times. When it comes to our viral vector development and manufacturing track record, we have been in operations since 2004, so 17 years. We have worked with 7 unique clients and produced more than 50 clinical GMP batches in 11 unique projects. So as you understand, we have some clients having more than one project with us. Our longest still active client is a relationship of 10 years. And for that client, we have supplied 9 clinical batches. And we have done so in all phases up to phase 3 and even commercial validation batches. We have all critical analysis in place, and we also hold the commercial manufacturing license for gene therapy products. When it comes to our viral vector production capabilities and equipment, we have a wide range of different equipment. We have worked on adherent cells and cultivation using HEC293, A45, A549 and Vero cells, etc. And in multiple multi-layer flask formats. We were also very early on adapting the iCellis bioreactor format. But as a company, we have decided to focus a bit more on suspension adaptation and suspension cell cultivation. That's because we think it's better scalability in that process. And in that, we have worked with HEC293, cap cells, SF9, etc. We have just opened a new ballroom concept clean room where you can roll in and roll out the equipment you need and adopt it according to your processes. In this room, we have up to 200 liter single-use bioreactors, but we also support wave reactors and smaller formats. On the chromatography purification side, we are heavily supported by Cytiva and their ECTA Ready systems, and which we also think is a good way of scale processes. But with that said, I should also say that we have ultracentrifugation-based purification as well, and have clients that prefer that, especially for their early clinical trials. And then at some point in time, they eventually go about and develop a chromatography-based purification process. We do have a tangential flow filtration, TFF, and much of our equipment these days are disposables. We have developed an internal rAAV process platform, including plasmid production upstream and downstream. The plasmid manufacturing pillar here would be to produce plasmids used as raw material in your process for triple transfection. If this obviously were an adenovirus process, then you would start with the seed stock, and that we can also manufacture for you, both a master viral seed stock and a working viral seed stock. We would also develop upstream processes and use those for manufacture of AAV, and downstream for purification, both for development and manufacture. There should also be a fourth pillar here, being aseptic fill and finish, which is also important, of course, in providing a comprehensive service. But this process, you are free to utilize as you please, either by improving your process or tapping directly into this. When it comes to analytical capabilities, I think I can say that we basically have everything product supporting in-house, and what we don't have in-house, we outsource. That would typically be adventitious virus, cell bank testing, mass spectrometry, and so on. But we do have infectious titer, transgene expression analysis, we have ddPCR, cell-based assay, sterility in-house, and so on. And when it comes to the last pillar, aseptic fill and finish, we do in for our viral vector in biosafety level 2 support up to 1,000 vials, which most of our clients consider quite a lot. And for AAV, if it's considered a biosafety level 1, we can support up to 10,000 vials. And we do so in both these filling lines in 2R and 10R vials. We do fill viral vectors, plasmid DNA, recombinant proteins. We could potentially fill small molecules, I guess, as well, but not so much. And dilution buffers. This is my last slide. It's a picture of the archipelago outside Turku, consisting of 40,000 islands. It feels sometimes as you can walk across Finland to Sweden on these islands. Obviously, that's not correct, but almost. And in short, we provide manufacturing happiness.